Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Mattel Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom Roarvoar's Triceratops. Surprised I didn't look at this earlier, as the Triceratops is my all-time favorite dinosaur. Did you know that? You probably do, as you probably have heard me say this through several of the Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom reviews. You know what we always do before we have a look at the dinosaur, we'll take some measurements. If I go from the tail, the end of the tail here, to the horn on the front, because that is the longest point, you're looking at the Triceratops being exactly 12 inches long. Then we'll go ahead and take the tape measure and put it to the top of its crest, and you're looking at about 4 1/4 inches. Let's do some size comparisons. So there's the Triceratops. We'll bring in the Carnotaurus. How about we bring in the Stegosaurus? You guys can see the difference between those two, or those three, I should say. Carnotaurus, I find he's very difficult to get to stand properly. And why don't we bring in some smaller dinosaurs too? Here, the Action Pack Raptor Blue, Action Pack Raptor Green, and why don't we even bring in the Dilophosaurus, just so you guys can have a whole lineup of dinosaurs to look at. There they are, all there. We'll try not to cover over the Triceratops. After all, he is the star of this review. So the category class for the Triceratops here is considered the Roarvoars. Not only do you have an action feature, something that moves on the dinosaur, but you also have the benefits of sound. I'm actually surprised that the Stegosaurus, I should say, only had the option to move the tail. I'm surprised they didn't incorporate some sound into it. But I guess they're doing it more so for the smaller scale dinosaurs and keeping the larger scale dinosaurs more just to the gimmick, more to an action feature, if you will. If we flip the Triceratops underneath, we are treated to a rather disturbing sight, some gashes in its underbelly. That's where the speaker resides. And that's actually going to allow it to prevent to have sound projecting outward. Of course, then you got the battery compartment right there with a little screw. It actually reminds me, when I'm looking at this, it just so happened that I saw the logo here on the underside of the Triceratops. It reminded me that I don't think I did a scan of the Stegosaurus, so I may actually have to do that. At the time that you're watching this video, I don't think I've posted the review yet. I'm certain I haven't, as I've just recorded it, so I may actually just tack on the scan of the Stegosaurus to the very end of that video. So you guys kind of, well, I guess you're seeing it in this video, but I'm probably going to post the Stegosaurus in the previous video, so you guys kind of get a little bit of behind the scenes. Needless to say, there's the QR code right there for the Triceratops, so we'll go ahead and scan that. I won't forget it. I won't tie a string around my finger, because I don't know, get why people do that, because they'll ultimately forget why they put the string on their finger. Getting ahead of ourselves here, the Triceratops is a glorious color. It's actually pretty close in colors to what we would see eventually when we look at the T-Rex. Very similar sort of color palette. You've got the darker brown kind of spreading its way out across the spine of the dinosaur onto an otherwise slightly orangey, rusted brown hide here. The skin is very reminiscent of what we've seen with the dinosaurs so far. You can clearly see that this dinosaur doesn't have speed going for it, primarily because it's a low four-legged riding dinosaur, and it's got a lot of, you know, softer areas to it. It's not a very muscular, fast, sleek looking dinosaur. It's imagining it'd be rather slow until it's charging at you. One of its true defense mechanisms and offensive attacks, of course, would be the very large spikes sitting at the front. These giant horns, you can imagine, would be impaling whatever it's charging its way to. It probably would not be a rather offensive attacking dinosaur unless something was attacking its nest, or, you know, again, it was defending its pack or grouping, if you will. It does have one horn in the front there. It kind of always reminded me of a rhino, and I know it's not of the same species category, but you can kind of see elements here in what will eventually be other species, even though it's not the. Don't anyone say it's not related to a rhinoceros. I know it's not related to a rhinoceros. Very large platelet happening on the back or top area of its head. The head is a little on the loose side. I mean, that will play a role when we are pressing the button on it. And by the way, if you are wondering where the button is, it's this section right here, as clearly indicated by this outline cutout here. This will be what we're going to press in a second. Weight-wise, it does have a considerable weight to it, factoring in that there are many electronic components in the interior. Of course, you've got the larger speaker in there as well. Does add for a little bit of a heavier dinosaur. In fact, if you are comparing it, as I was talking about it earlier, the unscanned Stegosaurus. Stegosaurus, despite its size, there's a lot more hollowness to it. So it actually does feel a lot lighter by comparing it to the Triceratops. Triceratops is a lot heavier by comparison. As for its articulation, the Triceratops does have basically your standard. I mean, the legs move forward and back, swivel back and forth, and they do also hinge. Initially, when I took it out of packaging, it didn't seem like it was the case, as you probably saw right there. A little bit of a cracking and creaking to get the legs to move outward. I don't know the benefit necessarily of having the legs be able to spread out that far, because it ultimately makes the dinosaur look a little silly when you are planting it firmly on its 4 feet. It is pretty much like the Stegosaurus, and it is pretty much like all the other dinosaurs we're looking at from the Jurassic World line, in the sense that even though they are poseable in the legs, really, what are you going to do with them? You're going to do this, or at the very least, you're going to compensate and kind of adjust the legs until they all feel as if they're firmly planted, and you're likely going to leave it. So any sort of articulation that's benefiting these figures really gets lost, because you're ultimately displaying it exactly what you're looking at right now, which is not necessarily a bad thing. I mean, it goes without saying, you're not going to be displaying them in action poses, these dinosaurs. You probably could do it with the smaller raptors. I mean, you could have some fun and take, like, the raptors, for example, and, like, have them attacking the... Such a morbid way to... So you could even take, like, Blue here and just have Blue lunging on top of the Triceratops. By the way, also, actually, it's a good thing I brought in this Blue. This was the Blue that came included with Owen. The one that had the open mouth. The one also that had the springing mechanism. Actually, it's so ironic that I'm bringing this into the video, because I just want to mention that I did figure out how to do the gimmick. Somebody had mentioned, a couple of people had mentioned that when I did the review of this one, that I wasn't doing it actually correct. And you'd be correct, actually, by saying that. So for the Blue, I'm just going to kind of bring the feet forward, and I'm going to kind of hold him down. I'm going to kind of hold him down like this. And then if you let him go, that's when he springs forward. Why am I doing this during the course of a Triceratops review? Just to show you. But the gimmick does work. I just wasn't doing it correctly when we were looking at Blue. So we'll just move him out of the way. As for the gimmick of the Triceratops here, it's simply a case of just pressing the button on the top. You'll see when I'm doing that, that the head will move and it will make some sound effects. So let's go ahead and do that now. By the way, the length of time in which you press the button down does not determine the length of the audio. If you hold it down, you get just as much of the audio clip as if you just press the button. And it cycles through about 4-5 different actual audio clips, which gives the toy some additional mileage to it. I mean, I would certainly appreciate just a Triceratops with the great coloring that it has here, some mild poseability as to be expected, but the fact that you got some extra audio in there definitely makes this a lot cooler. And making sure, of course, I didn't forget to do the scan on the Triceratops, I'm gonna go into scan. I did get myself a text in the meantime. We don't have to look at that just yet. But what we are going to look at is the scan of the dinosaur. So I'm going to hit scan. There we go. I'm going to line it up with the... There we go. Seems to be a lot easier to do these nowadays. And here, ladies and gentlemen, we've got ourselves the Triceratops, which just so happens to also say one of two. So I am wondering if there is maybe a secondary Triceratops. It seems awfully close to the screen. It's a shame that you couldn't... I know I sound like a broken record for saying this. It's a shame you couldn't zoom back, zoom in, rotate the dinosaur at the very least. But we will go in and we'll find out more about these. Now, one thing I didn't even mention before in the previous times we've scanned these dinosaurs is that the color will correspond with what exactly it is. So, for example, this is a herbivore, so it eats plants only. It does match it in the coloring down below. So we've seen a couple of red ones, for example, with like the velociraptors and stuff like that. So let's go in and let's find out a little bit more about my favorite dinosaur, the Triceratops. The name Triceratops means three-horned face. The Triceratops is about 26 feet long and 9.5 feet tall. And lastly, there is little evidence that Triceratops live in herds. There you go. My favorite dinosaur turned out exactly the way I would have wanted. Very bright, colorful dinosaur. Not much in the way of posability, granted, but it goes without saying what you're going to be getting from a dinosaur toy. If you're expecting super posability in a tail, in a head, you're probably going to be paying a little bit extra for it. As a result, though, I like that they kept the scale on these a little bit smaller so they could incorporate sounds. As a result, the Triceratops and a lot of the other roarivores cost, on average, about $22 to $24 in stores. They're not overly expensive, whereas if you had gotten a larger scale dinosaur, of course, the price would be a little bit higher. So it means that kids will be able to pick up a whole bunch of these and play around with them. And again, having the sound effects really goes a long way. The fact that you can also have a head that moves while it's doing the sound effects is an added bonus too. Yes, the Triceratops, I think I'm going in my memory banks here. I can't remember the last time I've owned a Triceratops, even though it's my favorite dinosaur. I think the last time I owned anything Triceratops related was when I was younger, and I had the shampoo bottle that just so happened to be a T-Rex or a Triceratops, and I played with that all the time, even though it had no posability. That's what it's like to be a child and using your imagination. You don't have to imagine a pretty cool dinosaur, though, because Mattel's really churning out some fun releases here, fun products, for the upcoming release of Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. If you're interested in picking up the Triceratops or any of the other roarivores, you can now currently find them fairly stocked. I think the Triceratops is one of the easiest to find of the roarivores, but you can find them in retail stores and toy stores as well. Today we were having a look at the Mattel, this was the Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, roarivores, Triceratops. Like this video? Hit it with a like down below. Want to subscribe to this video? Hit that little subscribe just below this video. We're going to have a look at some more Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom stuff. Whole bunch of new dinosaurs we're going to be checking out, so stay tuned for that if you guys want to go back and have a look at some other previously looked at Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom reviews. There's a playlist on this channel called... That's right, Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. You can go back and have a look at all that stuff. And speaking of which, this just reminded me now, I'm going to have to go back and still add that additional video to the end of Stegosaurus's review, because I didn't get a chance to scan the foot. I'm going to have to make sure I add that. So anybody who is watching the Stegosaurus review will just think it's normal business, but you guys know, you're kind of like behind the scenes on this video. You know I had to go back and add that video to the end of Stegosaurus. Shh, don't say anything. More videos, guys, will be coming your way. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.